I'm a professor of architectural history at Roger Williams University here in Rhode Island and also at the University of Lincoln in England. I'm particularly interested in relationships between England and America and also European precedents for architecture here in America. I'm particularly interested in Jim Egan's investigations of the Newport Tower. I think that he has shown conclusively that the tower was designed as a horologium or a timekeeper, and that it was also designed as a catechism, a three-dimensional model for instructional purposes, or an Aedificium of philosophical structures and philosophical ideas that were extremely prevalent during the Renaissance. And a building can represent these through through mathematical proportions, geometries. In the case of the Newport Tower, the presence of the camera obscura models of vision. And Jim has shown that these philosophies can be found in particular in the writings of John Dee, the famous statesman and philosopher in Elizabethan England, who was involved with colonizing efforts, and in particular an effort to colonize this part of Rhode Island. And there's a probable connection between the building of the tower and John Dee's efforts, and there's certainly a connection between the iconography that Jim reads in the tower, the meaning from the symbols, and the writings of Dee. He has discovered a previously unknown connection between Renaissance Europe and the United States, Elizabethan England and the United States, right? You know, it's important for the history of the American colonies and the relationship between England and the American colonies, and it's important for architecture in general. I mean, it puts, you know, a piece of the, you know, thousand-year-old tradition of European philosophy and history in early America, which is pretty amazing, right? I don't think there's any other example of that.